we don't want to become a witness to our own investigation.
So for Sean Spicer, it's you know that podium. It can be difficult at times. And all of a sudden, you have not just a political problem here with the Russia story, but a legal.
I got him recorded doing that.
And as you know, being at that podium, it can get sticky where you don't want to insert yourself in the
middle. Not being at podium, I was a spokesperson on the Valerie Plame issue for a long time. And do you have to be so careful when things are under investigation so that you don't look like you're trying to weigh in or interfere and that would be inappropriate? You also know that there's a lot of lives here that are involved, people that maybe it's completely innocent.
Well, especially since this is intelligence, you're right. And this is sensitive information. Some of it's been spilling out, and that's a whole other part of this, which is the unmasking of people, the unmasking of names, a whole other part of this investigation. So let's dig a little bit deeper right now as we wait for the White House briefing.
Showboat.
Press Secretary Sean Spicer is bringing our political panel. Shira Center, political editor for the Boston Globe, and Jesse Burns, associate editor of The Hill. Good to see you both.
Good to see you too.
He's doing a big open room.
What do you think about this in terms of the political drama for the White House, which has been playing out for a long time, but there's been a legal drama that now is maybe front and center because of the possibility,
get off your foot,
the underlying word possibility, of an immunity deal for General Flynn.
Now, I think any day that Michael Flynn
is ankles.
Is a Trump administration. This is a person who was forced to resign. It's not something Donald Trump wants to talk about. And I think anytime there's also an investigation into it, a House investigation or a Senate investigation, anytime that's
crazy dog.
A bad thing for Donald Trump, especially because